News that a COVID-19 vaccine has shown 90% efficacy in the initial stages of its clinical trials has sent a wave of hope throughout the globe for those who have been anxiously waiting for some positive news about the COVID-19 pandemic. But in spite of that, says Dr. Merle Clarke, there remains the glaring issue that a wide section of the global population has indicated that they would not be vaccinated even if a safe vaccine is developed. Since the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic, the anti-vaccine movement has mushroomed. Generally, it would take roughly a decade or two to develop a safe vaccine, but in the case of a COVID-19 vaccine, labs are working to get one approved in a fraction of that time. This reality, says Dr. Clarke, has anti-vaxxers even more skeptical.
The voice of the anti-vaxxers has been very loud. This, of course, stemming from the theory, which has been debunked, so it's a fallacy, that the MMR vaccine causes autism. And the anti-vaxxers' voice is not exactly a soft one. It's a very loud voice, and there's a lot of mistrust of the scientific community for multiple reasons, not the least of which is who is the current president of the United States, not speaking necessarily favorably of science a lot of the time. So there is a lot of work to be done in that regard.
Moreover, says Dr. Clarke, there is still the problem with an approved vaccine being available for small developing states like those of the Caribbean region. Countries with greater financial resources are poised, given their economic advantage, to acquire the majority of an approved vaccine. The WHO's ACT Accelerator Initiative was created to ensure equitable access to any vaccine developed.
For us in this part of the world, the Caribbean region, we probably would not be prioritized in terms of getting it if it were to be made available, because the reality is, on a global scale, there is global competition right now for anything which has been shown to have any sort of positive effect as it pertains to COVID-19. So would our region be prioritized? Probably not.
For the moment, says the SLMDA president, it is a wait-and-see game if approval is given for this vaccine. Pfizer plans to ask the U.S. Food and Drug Administration for emergency authorization of the two-dose vaccine later this month, after it has collected the recommended 2 months of safety data. The company is hoping to manufacture enough doses to immunize 15 to 20 million people by the end of the year. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.